In this video, we will look at the Trends application in the PME web client and how we can use it to monitor our system. If we go to the Trends menu in the PME demo website, we see a number of trends in the library on the left. Some of the trends are already selected as indicated by the green highlight are displayed in the main window. We will have to create our own trend configurations. However, for now, let's use the PME demo pre-configured trends to explore the trend application. We look at the first trend on the top, building natural gas. The first thing we notice is that there are two data series in this trend, temperature in orange and natural gas usage in green. There can be more than one data series in a trend. In PME 2021, it can be up to 14 data series in a single trend, which should be plenty for most use cases. Let's maximize this trend for better viewing. On the right, we see the legend, which we can choose to either show or hide. The legend shows the name and latest values for our two data series, temperature and natural gas usage. Now, if we examine the trend in the main window, we notice that. Notice that as we move the mouse cursor, we see the date, time, and values for the data series at that particular moment. Currently, the viewing period is 48 hours. We can adjust this by clicking on the drop-down selection on the upper right corner. The options for viewing period range from 1 minute to 1 year. I'm going to adjust it to 3 days. Another convenient tool is the inspection button, also at the upper right corner. If we click on the magnifying glass icon, we enter inspection mode. In this mode, two scroll cursors appear at the bottom of the trend. We can use these two cursors to zoom in on the trend data. Something else I can do is, while my mouse is in the middle of the window, simply use the mouse scroll button. This allows me to easily zoom in and zoom out of the trend. Another convenient feature of the inspection mode is that you can zoom in by selection while my mouse is in the middle of the trend. If I left click, hold it and drag a window like so and release the trend, application will zoom in exactly to the window that I drew. I can do this repeatedly until the data shows in discrete time intervals of 15 minutes. This indicates that the data is historical coming from the database. In contrast, if I zoom into the most recent 30 minutes to 1 hour, I can see that some of the data has better resolution than 15 minutes. Starting from 4:22 p.m. onwards, I have a data point every few seconds. This is because I selected this trend 4:22. While the trend is open, it has been collecting and showing data both historical from the database and real-time communication data from the devices. Note that this real-time data is only kept while the web client is open in the web browser cache. If I close this trend or close the web client, that real-time data will disappear. This is a unique function of the trends that allows us to monitor the trending of real-time measurements for short periods of time. It is not recommended to allow PME trends to continuously monitor real-time data without placing an appropriate limit on the data points, precisely to prevent from burdening the cache of the PME web client. Notice also that the data series is frozen in inspection mode. New real-time data does not come into the trend. Once I click Trend, the trend will resume trending mode and I can see the real-time data populating my trend once again. One last feature is the Export button. This will download the trend data as a CSV file. It is especially useful if we want to keep a copy of the real-time trend data. This concludes the introduction to trend application. In the next video, we will look at how to create and configure our own trends. Until next time, thank you.